We've seen teachers change 5 factors in their classroom to increase their students' motivation to learn. Concern, feeling tone, success, interest, and knowledge of results. No one of these factors is most important, nor are they discrete. Students vary in their response to them. What is high concerning is pleasant to a champion, but it may be unpleasant to someone who thinks they can't do it. What is fascinating to one student is of no concern to another. Lack of success may make some students try harder. It may make others give up. What about intrinsic motivation, you ask? Shouldn't students be intrinsically motivated? Intrinsic and extrinsic motivation exist on a continuum. If you're intrinsically motivated, learning itself is its own reward. If you're extrinsically motivated, you're learning to get a grade, a recommendation, or just to get it over with. It would be great if all our students were intrinsically motivated, but they're not. As we use the factors of concern, feeling tone, success, interest, and knowledge of results, we'll move those students closer and closer to intrinsic motivation, where the learning itself becomes its own reward. As you become sensitive to these factors, you'll realize you're using many of them already in your classroom. Now you can use them all, not intuitively, but on purpose.